Thank you,
he
Jesus.
He says, but you pray mysteries.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank you. in terms of your language or tongues. You began to see an expansion of your vocabulary. Hallelujah. Amen. You hear words come out of your mouth because God will add to your vocabulary. Because when you're doing a sprint like that, you don't have time to build up. And so the Holy Ghost will give you stuff at a moment. I'm telling you, you do it for about 3-4 minutes. I'm telling you, the Holy Spirit will give you words or vocabularies. And remember, you're not praying for anything intentional. You're just going out in the spirit realm. Hallelujah. You have a legal right to do that, you know.
Yes.
You do realize that you have legal access.
Yes.
You can access the kingdom anytime you want to.
Yes.
So let's use our passport of the Holy Ghost. Let's go out there more often. Amen. Amen. Some of you have a passport that you don't use, you don't travel. Before you know it, it will expire.
Yeah.
It will expire. You can spend all that money to get a passport and never use it. Never went nowhere. Won't even go to Canada with your lazy self. Come on, somebody. And here we have this passport in the spirit realm to go into the spirit anytime we desire. Hallelujah. You have received the gift of the Holy Ghost. He has given you access. Glory to God by the blood of the Lamb. And you got all this power at your disposal.
Yeah.
You got all of this power, all these resources, all of this wisdom, all of this knowledge, this genius mind of God. And you refuse, you dare not go out there every day. My God, come on, let's do it again. Come on, build yourself up. Build yourself up. Here Sunday, they didn't come here tonight.
Amen.
Now, you may not see it in the natural, But you learned something tonight that I can't teach them. Now, in a crisis, who you think got the advantage?
Yes.
You that had the Bible study, or you, them that are here to say maybe later, that don't show up, you're going to have the better advantage. And trust me, you have pulled some of them through.
Right, right.
Yes.
Because what you just learned, let me tell you something, what you just learned has saved my life countless times over. It has saved my life. Yes. Just that, what I just taught you. We can go home right now.
Yes.
Because what I just taught you has saved my life over and over.
Amen.
Over.
Amen. Yes. Yes. Yes.
You know what I just said? What you just got has saved my life.
Amen. That's true. Yes.
Knowing that tactic of war has saved my life. And it will save yours.
Yes.
Now, I'm trying to tell you the advantage of being in Tuesday night Bible study. I can't teach everything on Sunday. That's not the purpose of Sunday. Sunday is inspiration. Tuesday is information.
This is
where you get trained.
Yes.
To be skillful in spiritual warfare.
Yes.
So you can be deployed to do the work of the ministry.
Amen.
Whether it's in the marketplace or whether it's in the church. But you have to have some place where you go to be trained. Just because you come into the church don't mean you know nothing.
Right, right.
There's a bunch of people up in here on Sunday that don't know nothing.
Mm-hmm.
They're great people. They're loving people. But they don't know what I just taught you.
Amen.
Amen.
What I just taught you will save your life. Now, some of you want to have a strong prayer life. Your life is so busy. You don't have a time, a devotional moment. You're doing all kinds of stuff. So you need to know how to hit it. You know how to, you need to know strategies.
Yes. Amen.
You need to know strategies. Because you don't have 2 hours to put in every morning. You don't have 2 hours at night. So you need something, come on now, that will keep you in afloat and keep you aligned without losing your place. What I just taught you will save your life.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It'll show you how it's good. It'll show you how to prophesy. It'll show you how to you'll get words. The Lord will give you a word. I just gotta have yourself prophet. I'm sorry. I got all excited. sometimes I have time, you know, I'm on these planes and wherever I am, I don't know sometimes. But I'm telling you, just those short sprints in the spirit.
Yeah.
Amen. Sometimes that's how I preach. I just have to rely on
yes.
the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
To just do what I just did now.
And, amen.
And wait for him to drop
yes.
the mystery that he yes. desires to yes. share.
True, yes.
When you move into this place that I'm going to take you, when you move into this place, it's totally different. They don't teach this in school.
True.
They don't teach this in seminary.
Right.
It's not what I learned. I learned this on the field.
Right.
In the trenches.
Amen, yes.
I've been in the trenches. I learned this in the trenches.
Yes.
All that studying you do and all, you know, you go away, you look up words, and all that stuff we do.
Uh-huh.
There is a realm
yeah.
where you have to tap into.
Yes.
Where it's right. Revelation.
Right.
Amen. You have to know God by revelation.
Yes.
You can't study God. Amen.
Teach it here tonight.
You cannot study God.
Right.
You're going to have to know him by revelation.
Yes.
You got to hear what I'm saying.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
We're going to be a realm.
Yes. You got to know him by revelation. See, I need to know God.
I need to know God.
By revelation.
By revelation.
He said, oh, that means I got to spend a whole lot of time. I got to stay in the closet all day, and I got to no. See, you need a revelation on that. When you walk in the Spirit, when you practice hearing, you practice listening, you practice knowing the will of the voice of God, then the spirit of wisdom and the spirit of revelation will fall on your life.
Yeah.
Lift your hands. Lord, I desire
the
spirit of wisdom
spirit
and the spirit of revelation
spirit
to follow my life.
Follow my life.